As you may have seen from my previous videos, I'm a fan of original equipment manufacturer software. Even if it's crappy and bloated, it's interesting to experience exactly what a computer was like when you just bought it from a store, something which is impossible to replicate with a generic Windows installation disk. However, some PCs don't have much extra content in their original software, like this HP Compaq 6000. Here we're running the recovery program from its DVDs called Restore Plus. It allows you to set various partition schemes, in case you want to have separate partition for data or something, but I'm just going to have everything in one partition. Since I've already spoiled that there's not much bloatware here, we've got to install the one option of bloatware that's being offered to us. And there it is, doing its thing as normal. There's not much to see in this part, except... Doesn't it seem like it's rebooting to the same thing a bit too many times? I did this recovery process off camera before and it definitely didn't do that, so what's going on now? Well, long story short, I literally spent an entire afternoon trying to troubleshoot it. I checked the disks, they have no errors. I checked the BIOS settings. I tested the RAM with memtest86, because between the successful attempt off-camera and the current one, there was a RAM emergency that I managed to fix by reseating one of the RAM sticks, and also resetting the BIOS by removing the CMOS battery. The RAM turned out to be fine. I tried another set of recovery disks I found online, burning them to DVD-Rs to make sure my RW disks weren't the issue. Still nothing. I booted up a Linux Live USB drive and checked the partition layout. It seemed quite weird, only half of the drive was partitioned. But regardless of the settings here, even if I wiped the entire partition table, it would always end up like this. Was my SSD on its way out? I doubt that. Still under Ubuntu, I tried browsing for logs to see if they had any errors or anything unusual. But nope, I was seriously starting to think this computer was dying. Then I decided to sort the files by date. And that's when I noticed this. 2080? Really? Sure enough, that's what the date was set to. That must have happened because I took out the CMOS battery. How did it end up going to that year, and how did I not check the date settings earlier? After setting it back, I booted it up without even starting the recovery process from the beginning once again, and it continued. Holy moly. 10 hours. I spent over 10 hours until I found the root of the issue. Now, for real, there's not much to see here, so let's skip to the OOBE. And this would quite literally be the out-of-box experience, since it's not a generic installation of Windows. But this part is very similar, so let's proceed. Here we are at the Windows 7 desktop. The wallpaper is stretched and low resolution, probably because they figured you wouldn't have a 1080p monitor in a business setting in 2010. My HP Pavilion home PC from 2008 came with this background too, but it also had a higher resolution version. Here are the other two wallpapers it came with. Being from late 2009 or 2010, this is Windows 7 without Service Pack 1. And now the drive partition setup is correct. There is a small recovery partition, and the main partition is the rest of the drive. So let's explore the stuff that's on here. Here are the programs on the start menu. Here's McAfee Antivirus, which thankfully was optional. Here are some other things like user manuals. And something that claims to know how much power your computer consumes. It's probably better to look at an actual power meter. And probably the only interesting piece of software from HP, a conferencing software called Skyroom. This is basically the precursor to Microsoft Teams or Google Meet or Zoom, but in 2010. Businesses have had this kind of software for years, so that's not unusual. I don't think I can get it to work, but it's quite cool anyway. I could upgrade this installation to Service Pack 1 and all updates until 2020, or even Windows 10, but honestly, that's not worth it. I've done a clean installation of Windows 10, and it performs quite well, with drivers for everything. The integrated graphics aren't great, you can't play modern video games on it, but you can watch videos up to 1080p. It also works terrifically with the newest Linux distros like Ubuntu 22.04, unlike my ThinkPad with 1st Gen Core i5, where the Linux kernel 5.15 that many recent Linux distros use makes that computer freeze. This Core 2 Quad is more powerful than some early Core i5 CPUs. It can take up to 16GB of RAM. It only has TPM 1.2 and no EFI, but remember, it's a computer from 2010, which is 12 years ago now. It's not bad for its age, especially as a secondary PC. It may be a little old, but it's not actually old if it can still run updated software. That's about it for this video. Thank you for watching.